Now, let's see. When SX operates on this spin half particle, what it will give? The very first thing it will give h bar over 2. Clear? It will get h bar over 2. What this one is doing? It is 0 by 0 and 1 by 1. So it is spin up, it will make it spin down. So it will, what it will do, it will make this one will be equal to h bar over 2 and it will make it spin down. From spin up, it will become spin down. Then, what this one will do, it will again give h bar over 2, the eigenvalue, and it is spin down. So it will make it spin up. So h bar over 2, and it will make it spin up. Plus, what Sy will do with spin up? Sy is actually will produce I h bar over 2 is an eigenvalue. So I h bar over 2 is an eigenvalue, and it will also make this spin down. Because look here, 0, 0, 1, 1, the diagonals are on the other side. So it will make it spin down. If it is earlier spin up, it will make it spin down. If the diagonals were on this side, like in this one we will discuss, then what it will do. I h bar over 2 in spin up will become spin down. What about the next one? It is spin down. And the y component. Now look here, there is no minus here. But here we are having one minus. So it means that minus will come out. And it will make, as it is spin down, so it will become minus I h bar over 2. And what about the spin? Spin down, it will make is spin up. So you will have to keep this thing in mind. This one, I h bar over 2, only spin up became spin down. Here, it will make this one minus I h bar, because here it is spin down, and for spin down the minus sign will come out, and we will have minus I h bar over 2. You can check this one. Take Sy, apply it on 0, 1 as we have done earlier, then it will give you this result. And then plus, what about the this one, Sz? Sz when operates on spin up, does it change the state? It is not changing the state. Why? Because Sz was the orientation. It is not part of the lowering and raising operator. The X and Sy are part of the lowering and raising operator. So we will only get h bar over 2. H bar over 2, and it will remain spin up. Similarly, another one. As it is spin down, so the eigenvalue, it will give minus h bar over 2. So minus h bar over 2, and it will remain as spin down. Clear? So if this is right, then do multiply. What it will become? It will become h bar square over 4, because this value will come out. And when these two will multiply, it will be down and up. The first will be down and the next will be up. What about this one? I will make minus 1, while minus b with minus 1 become plus. So this is again h bar square over 4. And here it is down and this is up. So it means these two are the same. H bar square over 4, h bar square over 4. So this will come out to be h bar square over 4 I take is common. So this and this will come out to be 2 times. Right? So I can write that this one is h bar square over 4. And here I am having 2 times this. Down and up. Clear? This has become 2 times. And now come here. What this will be? H bar square over 4, but with a minus sign. So minus sign will come and then up and down. So I can write h bar square over 4 common minus, and this is up and down. So this is the value of S1 dot S2 on this stage. And then I will find, S1 dot S2, S1 dot S2 on which stage? On the second one, this one. It is down and up. And you will calculate it as we have done here, this way. And what you will get? You will get h bar square over 4 and 2 times, then it will be the opposite of it. Up and down is, we are now having down and up, so it will become up and down minus. This will be 1 time and it will be down, up, opposite to that one. Is these two are opposite to each other? So here we will have these opposite to each other. Now this will be opposite to this one. So we found this term. We found this term on this state. Forget about the 1 over 2 and the value here, but we have means 1 over 2 and this one. We will later on calculate this one, the numbers, but first we have found this one. Now what remaining? S1 square remains on this one and then this one. S2 square remains on this one and this one. Clear? So now we will move toward the S1 square on the one and on the other. So find out that S square on this. So we have, let me first do this whole for this whole, because we can write for the other terms first and then add up all, but I will have to go through the steps of your book. So now let me calculate S1 dot S2 on a state which is 1, 0 on the whole state. So what it will be? It will be first this value h bar square over 4, and then the square root term will come, which is 1 over 2, and then it will be on this one means first this value will come in for this state. So it is h bar square over 4 I have written two times the down up minus one time the up and down. Then it will be added plus h bar square over 4 is common already. 1 over 2 is common already. 1 over 2 is coming from here. So I will now add the addition, which is this one, and then it will be 2 times up and down. Is it fine? I have just found the whole term, this whole term on 1, 0 state. So what it will be is equal to, look here, this is 2 down up, this is 1 down up, so it will become 1. This one is 1 and this becomes this, so it will be in the form of addition, and I will have this thing equal to then 1 over 2, and now we will have from this one down up, this down up will be subtracted, so 1 down and 1 up will remain. Clear? Yes. Plus, look here, from this one now I will subtract this one up and down, so plus up and down will remain. So what is this whole thing? This whole thing is actually our 1, 0 state. So I can write that this is h bar square over 4 and 1, 0 state. Clear? So I found the whole term. Now I know another value, and that value is of S1 square, S1 whole squared, which is this value. It will apply on this state. S2 whole square will apply on this state. So what are those values? I know from my previous calculation that S whole square when applied on chi plus is what? 1, 0 state, means the up state. Like S square when operates on the up state, it gives 3 over 4 h bar square and chi plus. Right? Similarly, when S square operates on chi minus, it gives 3 over 4 h bar square chi minus. This you know. S square when operates on chi plus, it gives 3 over 4 h bar square the same state, while when it applies, it gives 3 over 4 and chi plus, means the same states. So what I can do, that when I will apply this one, I will get 3 over 4 h bar square in the same state. The same state will be what? This is the same state. I will get 3 over 4 h bar square 1, 0 state. And when I will apply the S2 square, I will get 3 over 4 h bar square 1, 0 state, because the state is not changed. So I will get the same result. I can then write that when I apply S square, this S square is this one, on 1, 0 state, what I will get? I will get 3 over 4 h bar square for S1 square. I will get plus another 3 over 4 h bar square for S2 square. S1 here is actually S square but on state 1. S square on state 2. As it is not changing the state here, it is not changing the state. So for the first one, 3 over 4 h bar square, for the second one, 3 over 4 h bar square, plus 2 times, what? S1, S2 on the state. So when 2 times, it is h bar square over, h bar square over 4, and this is the whole eigenvalue on 1, 0 state. Clear? Now simplify this one. What it will be? This will become, this is 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8. 8 over 4. So 2 h bar square 1, 0. And what we have told earlier, that we want to prove that S squared, these triplet configuration, if we take one configuration out of it, it will be the eigenfunction of S squared with n eigenvalue 2 h bar squared. And we got it. Now, back home, you can calculate that S square, when operates on state this one, instead of 1, 0, you take 1, 1. What eigenvalue it gives you? It is also an eigenstate. It is also an eigenfunction of S square. So you apply this one on 1, 1 and check that what eigenvalue it is giving you. You can apply S square on 1 minus 1 and check what eigenvalue it is giving to you. If you have any difficulty in calculating this one, you can discuss with me. Clear? Now, these all the three states, the triplet states, we have calculated. Now, what about the singlet state? Means what will be the result of 0, 0? Is the very first thing, is this will be an eigenfunction of S squared?